Hello everybody and welcome back to Zombie Zoology. I'm Zombie Zebra and today I'm doing a very important take a minute, and that is the take a minute for EHLERS Danlos syndrome. EHLERS-Danlos syndrome affects approximately 1 in 5,000 people. As more people are being diagnosed, it's sometimes starting to look like it's more like 1 in 2,500, but there's still a lot of research that needs to be done on the subject. So the EHLERS-Danlos syndromes are a group of connective tissue disorders that all manifest differently, have different symptoms. There are currently 13 subtypes, all of which have their own genetic causes and have their own specific symptoms. Now, there is a lot of crossover between these types, most of which is joint hypermobility, skin hyperextendability, and skin fragility. So those are three things to look out for when looking for the EHLERS-Danlos syndrome diagnosis, but there are specific diagnostic criteria for each different subtype, and I have made videos where I have read that new diagnostic criteria allowed, which I will link below. So joint hypermobility is when your joints are loose or unstable. Some people find that this manifests as joint dislocations. They'll also find that they are very flexible, which some people think, oh, that sounds so fun, but it can be very painful because our connective tissue stretches out without being able to take back to shape. You'll also often see different skin types. Sometimes they find soft, velvety skin. Sometimes it is hyperextendable. That means you can pull it further away from the body than a normal person's skin can. And they'll also find easy bruising and skin fragility. This means scars that don't heal well, bruises that seem to come out of nowhere. You'll also find things like artery, intestinal, or even uterine fragility, or even rupture, all of which are obviously awful and can be very life-threatening. Those are normally associated with vascular type, which can affect life expectancy. So it is important to get diagnosed with EHLERS-Danlos syndrome, especially if you end up having vascular type, because there are preventative measures that can be put in place. Each type of EHLERS-Danlos syndrome is defined as a distinct problem in making or using one of the types of collagen. Collagen is what the body uses to provide strength and elasticity to tissue. Normally, collagen is a strong protein that allows tissue to be stretched, but not beyond its limit, and then safely return that tissue to normal. An analogy that is often used is the wicker basket. There are lots of different pieces of material that are woven together to make that wicker basket, and if even one of those strings frays, a lot of the wicker basket will fray away. So even though there are lots of proteins and lots of different types of collagen that go into producing the body and the connective tissue of the body, even just that one type of collagen being produced ineffectively weakens the entire structure. Since collagen is found throughout your entire body, in your skin, in your arteries, in your intestines, in your joints, since it's everywhere, it affects everything. Sometimes I'll come across people who are like, oh, being EDS is just being double jointed. And that is not accurate at all. Having EDS is sometimes not being able to digest your food because of gastroparesis. It is passing out if you stand up too quickly because of POTS. It is 1,001 things. So what can you do to help? May is EHLERS-Danlos Syndrome Awareness Month. And the most prominent EHLERS-Danlos Syndrome fundraising attempt is coming from the EHLERS-Danlos Society. I'm going to link them below to their donation page. If you would like to donate, we would really appreciate it. The tagline for May for the EHLERS-Danlos Syndrome Awareness Month is Dazzle Together, because a group of zebras is called a dazzle, and together we are going to raise awareness for EHLERS-Danlos Syndrome. If we could just get EHLERS-Danlos Syndrome in the public eye, there would be less ignorance that we face every single day. Because sometimes society and people and the way they handle my health is way more exhausting than the problem with my health itself, which is, believe me, saying something. So if you wouldn't mind sharing my videos, share the posts on my Facebook page trying to spread information, just help me get information out there. It will be plenty to make me a happy little zebra during EHLERS-Danlos Syndrome Awareness Month. Thank you so much for watching this video. I know this video was longer than a minute, and I am not sorry about it. So until next time, hoard those spoons, guys.